लाइव लाइव
Hi everybody, a great afternoon and welcome back to our success story series. And the accompanying theme for the day is challenges in the school system in the current scenario. So folks, we all don't grow when things are easy. We rather grow when things are challenging. I'm sure you agree with this, and if you're in sync with what I just said, do raise your hands. A virtual raise, of course. So friends, we all discuss a lot on successes, the success stories, but seldom do we talk about challenges or even acknowledge them. So I guess today is the platform to discuss about challenges, and it's going to be a 1 hour of question and answers on the challenges that the school system is facing. So with that, I once again welcome you all on behalf of School Skies and APJ Consultancy. This is Dr. Praveena Jagdish, founder of School Skies, and it is a pleasure to be your host for the day. So quickly setting the context for the meeting, we have one very fascinating success story, that of Bhavan's Perum Thiruthi, Calicut. So glad to share that this is the second school that School Skies is onboarding, the first being Bhavan's Chebbiyur. And to talk about that, we have their principal, Mrs. Shreeja Unnikrishnan, as the first speaker. Next, we have Dr. Ajit Prasad Jain to address all our questions and concerns on the school system currently. And of course, he is a strong believer that smooth seas do not make skillful sailors. So he is someone who is adept to handling challenges. And lastly, I would love to elaborate a bit on the digital challenges faced by schools. So with that, I take the honor of introducing our first speaker, Mrs. Shreeja Unnikrishnan, who started her career as a teacher in 1992 at Bhavan's Balamandir, has rendered 25 years of service at Bhavan's Chebbiyur, and is currently elevated to the position of principal at Perum Thiruthi Bhavan's. Ma'am, it's such a pleasure to have you here with us, and I'm sure you're going to talk about your success story. I just have a request, request to you. Please do share your challenges and how your stakeholder responded when you made that quick jump in the technology bandwagon. And I know that it's an yellow alert there in Calicut, and despite that, I'm sure your classes are going on. I guess that's the advantage of having technology with you. So over to you, ma'am. We'd love to hear from you.
Thank you. Namaste. Good afternoon, Ajit Prasad Jain sir, Dr. Praveena Jagdish, and all who have joined us online. Myself, Shreeja Unnikrishnan, I am the principal of Bharati Vidya Bhavan School, Perum Thiruthi, Calicut. Now, ever since the foundation stone of Bharati Vidya Bhavan was laid by Shri Dhirubhai S. Mehta, the Secretary General of Bhavans, in 2004 and inaugurated in the same year, our school has made tremendous progress in creating a futuristic model of schooling, and we are giving training not only in to excel in academics but in arts, sports. In addition to this, we are giving special coaching in all sporting events in our school, which is something which is solely seen in Bhavan's Calicut. Ours is a senior secondary school, and our mission is to create an environment where our children can blossom into good, responsible human beings. Now, we all of us know that the two best teachers in the world are life and time. Life teaches us to make good use of time, and time teaches us the value of life. These are not my words. I'm quoting our former president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Why I quoted him is, this is very apt in the present scenario when the whole world is suffering and we are all in fact living with the COVID pandemic. And the major question which haunted us in the month of March was, what will happen to the education of our students? That is a major concern for all of us because of this microbe which has brought the world to a standstill. But as all of us know, there is always a solution behind every problem. And that's why I'm here to share the success story of the online classes of Bhavan's Perum Thiruthi with Microsoft Teams and School Skies. When the lockdown started, initially, we started our classes with WhatsApp because that was what was freely available with us. And the teachers sent recorded classes to the students. But soon they started coming to me with all their concerns. They miss the smiles, the anxious and curious faces, the queries, the responses of students. It was totally a different environment for them. So then they started complaining, ma'am, this will not work out. Then we shifted on to Zoom app. As all of us know, even though it was very difficult for teachers, they finally managed to take the classes, but there are many difficulties which we faced in Zoom app, because after every 40 minutes we have to reschedule the classes, and there were no tools which are required for an online class in Zoom. And that was the time when I came across a post in All India Bhavans Principals group by Chennai Rajaji Vidyashram principal about a new platform, the Microsoft Teams and School Skies. I immediately contacted Dr. Ajit Prasad Jain sir, who gave me the guidance, and also Dr. Praveena Jagdish, who very well agreed to all our concerns, and she immediately responded, and that's how we started our journey with Microsoft Teams. I discussed the matter with the management, the PTA, and my colleagues, and we proceeded to tie up with them. Thanks to Ajit Prasad sir and Dr. Praveena for their timely guidance and support given extended to us. Now, when I presented this matter to my colleagues, initially there was reluctancy from their side. As usual, we know there is often the fear of whether it will succeed or not whenever a new thing is implemented. But I promised and convinced them that I will not proceed unless and until each and every teacher of our school, right from the KG to the postgraduate teachers, everyone is well trained to use the platform. Then we discussed the matter, and ultimately with the School Skies, and they offered us training program. After the first training program, still teachers had some difficulty, some of them had more queries. So I again contacted School Skies, and they readily arranged a second training program for us. And by the end of the training program, all the teachers, they felt more confident, and then they started hands-on training among themselves. They formed groups and they acted like children, and they started off with their classes. And within a week time, you won't believe, they were all well equipped to use the Microsoft platform. I also take this opportunity to thank Manjuna, the computer resource person, and the HOD of Computer Science Department, Rajeshri VK, for the timely support given to the teachers in handling these classes. Thus started our journey. To my surprise, when teachers started taking the classes, I expected more problems, but the problems were very less. And the most challenging part was convincing parents. First thing what we did was we took feedback from all the parents, and I ensured that every child at every houses, every child of our school is equipped with the device to start the class. And the PTA has supported us like anything for this. And soon all issues were resolved, and teachers, parents, and students, they easily adapted to the online classes through Microsoft Teams. What I found interesting here is the availability of many tools which are very essential for an online class. First and foremost, the attendance of students. We could mark the attendance. There's a whiteboard facility, a space for sharing files. Teachers can share their screen, video sharing from YouTube. They can bring a lot of audios and videos and they can share them. Teachers could even share their PowerPoint presentations. There is a notebook space for students, as well as a space for teachers to give assignment. The informs, a space where teachers can give questions, MCQs and other questions can be posted. Not only that, the screen share option has helped the teachers a lot in sharing many learning enhancing contents. Then chat option is also available. Not only that, we have conducted all the tests. We did not miss out any of the tests. We conducted all the tests through this online mode of Microsoft platform. And all extracurricular subjects like yoga, music, drawing, dance, PT, work experience, all these were taken through this platform on Saturdays. And that is what children miss a lot, more than their academic subjects. And recently, last month, they have introduced gallery view, wherein 40 screens can be viewed simultaneously by the teacher. And also there's a grid view where 24 screens can be seen. This is a great advantage. And that's possible only if the teachers are using a computer or a laptop. Now this this 40 screens is a must, because minimum a class strength is, maximum strength a class is 40. And teachers need to see the child, what the student is doing. And that is what the gallery view is offering us. And not only that, we can make people presenters, we can make them attendees. And unlike the Zoom application here, what I found was more number of participants can be engaged at the same time, which is an added advantage for holding special programs for students. Now I'm conducting all my staff meetings. I'm scheduling it through this platform. Not only that, every subject meeting conducted by the HODs, each head of departments, is being done through this platform. And we are also having class-wise meetings with the between the teachers and the parents through Microsoft platform. And the main success of this online class is live sharing of the programs at school. You know, classes we can manage, but what about the programs? Children will be mainly missing all the programs. As soon as school reopens, we have many programs for the entire year. So first we started off with World Environment Day celebration, felicitation of the toppers of 10th and 12th, the Yoga Day, Music Day, Independence Day celebration, Onam celebration, Teachers Day celebration, even fancy dress competition. You won't believe, we had it through this platform. And few teachers we gathered, and we conducted all these programs at school, and it was shared live with the students. Unlike otherwise, felicitation of toppers, only the 10th and 12th teachers used to watch them, because others will be engaging the students in the classroom. But now, all the teachers, the entire school, even the students and their parents could view these programs. And that was an added advantage to it. And this gave the feeling to children that they are viewing the programs from school itself. Thanks to School Skies for giving us free sessions for the parents, students and teachers. There were training programs, how to reduce strain on eye in an online class. That was a big challenge. We know MHRD has given guidelines not to allow children to sit in this screen viewing should be limited. And we have major concerns how to cover the portions. So long hours of viewing the screen will definitely cause strain and stress on the eye of students. So this is one advantage which we got during the training program. And School Skies, they had a tie-up with the Kaveri Hospital, Chennai, and there was a session with Dr. Bindu, who had taken the class on how to reduce the strain on eye. And our parents have sent me a token of appreciation for organizing such a program. Thanks to Dr. Praveena Jagdish. And one more session was arranged with a pediatrician, which was also widely appreciated. And that was regarding what sort of a diet should children have during this lockdown period, which can boost their immunity. And that was also a big success. Likewise, we are organizing cyber security classes and many other classes through this session. We are able to give them all these. In addition to this Reader's Day celebration, we had a story time for children, which was also hosted, and children loved this program. This would not have been possible without this platform during this lockdown period. Now, not only that, and the important thing is, you know, unlike other usual occasions, now parents have realized the potential and the efforts taken up by the teachers, because they can see what the teachers are doing in the classroom. Earlier, that facility was not available to them, but now they are seeing the teachers, what are the pains and that the teachers are taking, the effort they are bringing in to impart this knowledge to students. And I'm getting very good feedback about my teachers, more than in bountiful, more than what I used to get earlier, because they are all now exposed and the parents are all convinced now what teachers are doing. This is a success story with Microsoft Teams and School Skies. And I would like to share a few of our live programs, just few photos of our live programs. These are the classes right from KG to 12th standard. The class is the subject channel where each subject teacher can go in and choose the subject, whichever is their subject, they can choose it and they can start the classes. This is a gallery view which I mentioned, where children can be viewed by the teacher. There's a video recording option also. The video can be played later on, yes. And this is an assessment portal where children, teachers can give them the assessments. Now these are glimpses of our autumn celebration which we had at our school. We had Pulikali, the Tiruvadirakkali and group song. And also our PTA all joined us, and they have given gifts to the non-teaching staff of the school, and the entire school was watching this program live. And this is the felicitation of toppers, our chairman, Shri AKB Nair, and the topper of our school, Avinash. And this is how we presented it. This is a glimpse of the Independence Day celebration. And this is our vice chairman, Shri Hari, sir, giving the message on felicitation of toppers. Now this is, as it's mentioned earlier, Reader's Day, and the story time for children. Thank you. Once again, I thank each and everyone who has joined us. Thank you all. Thank you, Praveena. And over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. I think those are wonderful insights from you. And for us at School Skies, we're really proud to be partnering with your school. And I think the crux of what you said were two important things. One is the training, the skilling part that you've been able to offer, or rather as a team that we offer to the teachers, really helped. And the next is you very intelligently got the confidence of the parents. So that, I think, is your success. And more importantly, I think you were very happy that you were able to conduct all events, which is a big deal. Yes. So I think that was again a very nice thing to hear for us. So I wish you all a great journey ahead, and I hope more and more learning is ahead for you. Thanks. So with that, thank you, ma'am. So with that, we will quickly move to our second speaker for the day, Dr. Ajit Prasad Jain, Director, APJ Consultancy, ex-governing member, CBSE, Delhi, a national awardee, and sir is an able administrator, and he is a leader who's determined to face challenges. So we got a lot of questions for you, sir, and I'm going to just start with this. Generally, there are, with the NEP being out today, in alignment with the national education policy, there's a lot of commotion and confusion. What do you think are the major challenges that our stakeholders are facing today, sir?
Actually, when you look at the topic what given, challenges in the current scenario. So I could say the challenges are two. One is due to COVID, what are the challenges? And second one is due to NEP 2020. When you take the challenges due to COVID, the four people are involved in that. One is management, other one is teachers, then parents, and then students. So these four category people are facing the challenges due to COVID pandemic. If you take due to NEP 2020, there are only two, the management and teachers. No way the students or students and parents are affected. Not much affected. There may be some affection, but not much affected. So therefore, I would like to divide the challenges into two parts. One is due to COVID, the other one is due to NEP 2020. You want me to go tell me topic wise and category wise what are the challenges they are facing?
Okay.
Now let me take the first topic due to COVID. The challenges for the management. Now in every WhatsApp group, there is a speculation that the schools are going to open in the month of October. And in Tamil Nadu, the message is going viral that Tamil Nadu government has decided to open the school on October 5th. But we have to decide anything on that like that. But the same thing is happening in Karnataka. The same thing is happening in Andhra Pradesh. I hope the same thing will be going around in Kerala also. So therefore, the first challenge for the management in the opening of the school is creating the new vertical in the infrastructure. Now we know we have 40 children and 45 children, and especially in all Bhavan schools across the country, in all the 78 schools, no school is having less than 40 in any class. Number one, because it is an all India institution. Number two, we are getting inter bhavan transfer, so we do not know how many people are getting transferred from one place to other place. And schools which are situated in the cities like Chennai, Hyderabad, Calcutta, and Delhi, and Calicut, and Cochin, and Trivandrum. These are all the most affected schools because we cannot have control over the number 40. So the first challenge is creating the infrastructure for the management. Second is creating a new set of staff apart from the existing non-teaching staff and class four employees. We need to have a sanitization staff separately, which is another new vertical for my challenge for the management, and also cleaning of the bathrooms and restrooms and the computer science lab, and especially the science lab where one set of children are touching the apparatus and doing experiments and going away, and then the second set is coming. So before that, the it has to be cleaned, and it has to be, all these years it should be cleaned, but now it has to be disinfected. That is, it has to be cleaned and it has to be disinfected. So therefore, there are a lot of administrative changes, challenges for the management. And the other thing is, I think you must be having a separate question on financial crisis. So I will answer that. I will take it up at that point. And for the teachers, I cannot say it is a challenge, but it is something different from the routine. Now, no government, neither the state government nor the central government, MHRD or CBSE, is going to allow for at least another 1 year full strength of children in a class. So they are going to be divided into two sections, and for 22 only they are going to allow. So therefore, the teachers have to take or repeat the same lesson once again the next day. So it is another challenging part for the teachers, and also I do not know, maybe 20% or 30% online classes, and the rest of the lessons may be taught in the classroom, and these are the lessons to be taught through the online classes. CBSE may come out, so they are working on it. So therefore, the teachers should be able to ready with the material for online class separately, for a real classroom separately. So these are the challenges for the teachers. And for the parents, keeping the child and informing the child about the social distancing and not to share the materials what they are taking to the school with their friends, and most importantly, sharing their lunch or snacks with their other children. So these are all the challenges. They may say, they may advise, they may plead, they may request, but finally, when the child enters the school, once he go and sit with this peer group, what is coming out from the peer group, that is only going to happen. So neither the principal, nor the class teacher, nor the coordinator, nor the vice principal, nor the parent can do anything on this. So what is going to happen? We have to wait and watch. So these are the challenges for the parents. So these are management for the infrastructure, additional staff, and buying of sanitation material, and fumigation of the entire premises once in a week. So these are all the additional challenges for the management. And the teachers, I already told you that they have to be ready with the two sets of teaching methodology. And for the parents, making the children ready to go home, go to school. And also the parents are going to face another challenging factor in terms of transportation. if they are if I remember correctly, the Bhavan school in Calicut and the Bhavan school in Cochin, they mostly depend on the school transportation, and every school is running more than 40 or 30 buses. So when the SOP is going to come that only 50% of the capacity of the bus or van should be allowed, how we are going to carry the children from their home to school when the parents are not afford to buy a car and drop the kid? And the same thing is going to happen with the private transportation operators also. So a private operator who is having three vans, he is now bringing 20 children in each Tempo Traveler or Tata Ace. Now he has to buy another three because he cannot bring all the children in the same trip. And the problem is the timing is the same, so he cannot make two trips. So these are the other challenges for the management in terms of transport. And parents also, I told you about the transportation. And students, they have to be ready with the ordinary days school. So especially topics like chemistry, organic and mathematics, Monday the teacher will teach something, and Tuesday is off, and Wednesday again the child will come. By the time you come to Wednesday, you'll forget what has happened on Monday. So these are the challenges for the students. So this COVID has put challenges for the management, for the teachers, for the parents, and for the students. This is due to COVID. Now, if you take due to NEP 2020 for the management and teachers, for the management, the main part is there are a lot of changes are going to happen. Now we have Central Board of Secondary Education, CBSE, to which we are affiliated, and it is conducting the inspection for new affiliation and the extension of affiliation and conducting the examination. Now, the NEP 2020 says all the boards are going to be renamed as Board of Assessment. Now, if you take that, now the present Central Board of Secondary Education will become Central Board of Assessment. It is no more going to be secondary school, secondary education board. It is going to be Central Board of Assessment. Similarly, Kerala Board of Education, it is going to become Kerala Board of Assessment. So therefore, assessment only they are going to do. Affiliation part, they are going to have a separate body. 3-5-8 examination, they are going to form a national body. And no individual school is going to conduct the examination for 3-5-8. They are only going to teach. And the 3-5-8 examination will be conducted by a separate body. If I remember correct, the name of the body is Parak. Right? So we are only going to teach the children, and nobody knows who is going to set the question paper. That means the kind of a fear of a board examination, a common examination, is going to come in the minds of both the teacher, parents, and the students for class 3, 5, and 8 examination. And also, they are going to have a separate board to look into the affiliation and other part of it. So therefore, there are going to be different boards and different controlling authorities. So the challenges before the management is to whose SOPs they have to oblige, to whose SOP they have to make ready the campus. And for the principal and teachers, where they are going to answer, or who is going to give answer for if they have any query on some certain academic matters. So these are all the challenges for due to the NEP 2020 for the management and teachers. And for principal, same thing. Principal is a problem for fees, is a problem for transportation, it is a problem for conducting the online classes, it is a problem for maintaining the health condition of the school. So all the problems are going to sit on the head of the institution. So it is really going to be a head of the institution. So everybody is going to have a headache only. So these are the challenges for the teachers and the principals due to NEP 2020. So I thought I have covered. And for the teachers, in my opinion, as an educator, they are going to have a lot of challenges. It is very clearly given that after 1 year of service, and in the present condition, after 1 year of service, you will have an increment. But that NEP 2020 says there is no such condition. 1 year long service is not going to be the criteria for giving your increment. They are going to form NPST, National Professional Standards for Teachers, and they're going to formulate SPST, State Professional Standards for Teachers. And for both, they are giving two different indicators, two kinds of indicators. One is R indicators. They are giving very clearly. The teachers will have two types of indicators in assessing the in the appraisal. So every teacher will be appraised based on these two types of indicators. First indicator is R indicators, and bracket they are giving non-negotiable. That means no questions asked. These are all the things you have to follow. These are things you have to satisfy. Okay, what are the R indicators? After reading out the list, I am sure all the principals are going to clap their hands, because this is going to address all the daily problems. And madam is going to say, yes, Ajit sir, you are right. Number one, R indicators. Number one, attendance regularity. Number two, punctuality. Number three, financial preparatory. Number four, not using corporal punishment. Number five, participating in any mandatory school function and meetings. These are the five odd indicators, and every principal will agree, because all the problems of the staff are addressed. First, leave taking. Second, late coming. Third, corporal punishment, which is a perennial problem for all the principals. We are all holding our breath as long as we are a principal. Which parent is going to go to the police station because of the corporal punishment given by some teacher or other, right? So corporal punishment and attending the school functions and meetings compulsorily, regularly. These are all the five odd indicators. Now, soft indicators are effective pedagogy and classroom practice, effective development assessment of progress of students, and effective use of teaching learning material, and quality of engagement, interaction with the parents and students. So once this is given, and no principal will get any complaint from any parent that your maths teacher was arrogant, your social science teacher was arrogant with me when I attended the PTA. And similarly, the children cannot give a complaint to the principal that teacher is partial and she is arrogant with me, she is always fighting with me, she is always scolding me, she is always making me to stand outside this and that. So whoever has drafted the part of professional development for teachers 5.3 and 5.4, they have applied their mind and they have taken all the concerns of the principals of each and every school and college, school education or education, and they have drafted very nicely what are the indicators for the professional development and the appraisal form. And based on this appraisal only, the teachers will be given increment. So increment is not mandatory, since because I have served one donkey year of service or two donkey year of service, I should get my selection grade because I have done 10 years of service. Nothing is going to work out. It is all based on your own way of teaching, your own way of handling parents, your own way of handling children, and your own way of coming to school in time and attending the school properly and taking care of your teaching and taking care of your evaluation. So each and every part, if you allow me to say, 360 degree, the teacher is being assessed. Based on that, the teacher is going to be given increment. So this is another challenge for every teacher, because not all teachers are alike. Somebody will think, what I taught in the class, that's enough for what salary, what this management is giving, that's enough for me. Okay, but there are certain teachers, whether I'm getting paid or not, it is my duty, it is the future of my children, so I have to teach them, I have to make them understand. It is not only my duty to finish the portion, but also at the same time, it is my duty to find out how much it has gone into the minds of my children. So there are that kind of teachers also there, right? There are certain teachers, those who just come to school and they have parallel set of so-called tuition centers running around after the school hours. That is why they have added financial proprietary. So I don't know whether they are going to make how the MLAs and MPs have to submit their list of properties before election and after election, like that before entering the job or before first year, before the end, beginning of the year, what is your property? And at the end of the year, what is your property? I don't know what is going to happen, but what I could guess, every single portion of aspect of teacher development has been taken care in the form of teacher appraisal. Therefore, this is a major change in this present commission. I have not seen any such detailed reporting about the appraisal for teachers in the previous commission. So this is another big challenge for a normal teacher, or a teacher who is namesake teacher. A sincere teacher need not worry about it. They will do the job and they will get the salary, they will get their increment, etc. But for namesake, those who are coming and going, those who are taken, no other goal, so I come here. For such people, really, this is going to be a challenge. So therefore, I think for a single question, I have taken more than 20 minutes to answer.
No, sir, that question kind of answered most of the other questions as well. So we just have one that you were mentioning about pedagogies. So let's say, how are we going to do evaluations? Is it fair to conduct evaluations and examinations at all for the other classes, at least for the high school, for the lower class kids? So how are we going to do it? Are we going to forego it?
Okay, I agree. But one thing everybody is forgetting, every politician, everybody is making hue and cry, 3-5-8 examination, why for the children examination? But at the same time, we have already Right to Education Act 2009. RTE 2009 says no examination and no detention up to 8th. And now they made some changes. So my only worry is my own individual worry or doubt whether this RTE 2009 is going to clash with NEP 2020, because the NEP 2020 is announcing examination at 3-5-8. but they have never said anything about the promotion, whether all to be promoted up to 8th, all to be promoted, nothing they said. So therefore, we need to wait and watch based on this NEP 2020, what the NCERT, the apex body of Indian education system, which is going to give us the NCF 21, National Curriculum Framework 2021. It is going to come in the month of March. So NCF 2021, what it is going to come out? Because these are all the broad guidelines given by NEP 2020. So based on that, the NCERT is working for its NCEP 2021. So then only after that, we can able to say what will be the outcome of the examination, how it is going to be evaluated, and whether it is going to be online examination or offline examination or written examination. All the questions can be answered only once the NCEF 2021 is out.
Okay. So, sir, then there's this question, I think, which we need to discuss. So currently private schools are definitely facing financial crisis, and a lot of school sustainability is becoming an issue. So your comments or your suggestions on that, how do they look at it in the long run?
I don't know whether it is a coincidence or not. When we are discussing about this, this morning only I saw in one of the All India Principals group that there are more than 1,000 schools have come for sale only in the southern part of India. So only in South India, more than 1,000 schools have come for sale. Even as a matter of fact, even I have more than 12 schools in my hand looking for buyer. So therefore, yes, this pandemic has created a financial crisis, not only for schools, but also for parents, but not for all parents, because parents, those are working in companies and government sectors, have served both state government and central government, and but those who are having their own businesses, they are affected. Those who are going on a daily wages, because when you are talking about parents, we should talk about all kinds of parents. We should talk about the parents of government school, we should talk about the parents of CBSE school, we should talk about the parents of state board schools, we have to talk about the parents of IB school, IGCSE schools, all the parents. So therefore, yes, the parents are affected, the managements are affected, the teachers are affected, but slowly it is coming out of it, and slowly now parents have started paying the fees, and slowly the managements are also getting funds. So therefore, in my opinion, iduvum kadandhu pom, this also shall pass, maybe in another 2 months or 3 months. From next academic year, I don't think, because NEET examination has been conducted, right? So we have proved to the world that Indian government and Indian education system can face any challenges. So my dear friends, those who are watching this program, please don't think that the CBSE will not conduct the board examination in the month of March 2021. It shall conduct, because already the work for the compartmental examination is on, and 2 days back you must have received your guidelines for center superintendent. So therefore, conducting the examination in the pandemic period is possible. The CBSE has proved, the NTA has proved. So therefore, once there is a target that the board examination is going to happen in the month of March 2021, then definitely the schools will work towards preparing the children, and the parents also will send the children to the school. Whatever happens, at least the school going children. That is why everybody is talking from October 5th, we will send the children from, allow the children from class 9 to 12. So therefore, this financial crisis, it's only a temporary phenomena, and it shall pass.
So that was nice to hear, sir. So you are definitely showing us light at the end of the tunnel. So it shall pass is a very resonating statement. It feels good to hear that, and thank you for that, sir. I think that was a stupendous insights from Dr. Ajit Prasad Jain on various aspects of schooling, the infrastructure part, the parents, teachers, and different stakeholders. So well said, sir. You definitely have to take a few more questions. Probably at the end of the session, we will be having that from the audience as well. So thank you so much for joining us here, Dr. Ajit Prasad Jain, sir. And with that, I am going to move to my part of the session, which is going to be challenges on the digital front alone. So folks, like you all know, this year life in itself has changed in a big deal. All aspects of living has been affected, or it's rather changed directions due to the COVID pandemic. And definitely schools cannot insulate themselves from facing this drastic challenges. So the idea, or rather the future, is on how we actually convert these challenges into opportunities and how we move forward. So that's going to be the winning or the tipping point for the schools. And for this, there are two major challenges that we as a tech companies look into it. So one is the digital divide. So that has to be addressed at a national front, and it's not something that you or I as an individual can do. And as far as the people or the educators who've joined here, I am guessing that most of them have already made the transition into the digital front, and they're either going smooth or having mild challenges in taking their classes or lessons. There is the next thing is the transition from offline to online. This is a challenge that we definitely can work together and we can address, like what Madam was telling, how they had trained their teachers and how that made a big difference to them. So these are the two areas that we need to look into. And now coming to online learning, I would say is very much akin to a culinary experience. It is a combination of content and delivery. It's like food and the way you present the food, and both of this go hand in hand. So when we talk about content and delivery, it has to be tightly integrated. That again is very important, that both content and delivery is tightly integrated. So now coming to the point one, content. So there are a couple of ways you can look at things. One is the school or able to afford an LMS system? Can we take a learning management system and give it to the students? Or there are a lot of schools which are doing extremely well with the teacher created content itself, and for that teachers are and can use a lot of open sources and government initiative platforms like Deeksha. There is National Repository of Open Education Resources, Swayam, which has a lot of digital aids and resources, Swayam Prabha for the K-12 segment, and of course a lot of YouTube content has come up from various private players, and not all of that is going to be patented, and a lot of it is available on the YouTube itself, which many of our schools are using. So next, coming to the delivery. So content we spoke about. So delivery, you all know, you all would have come across these apps which are like standard industry standard apps, like Google Meet is there, WebEx Cisco is there, Zoom is there, Microsoft Teams is there. So while I would like to state that all of these are wonderful apps and they may be great corporate apps, there are mild differences, and you have to evaluate on what fits your school system. So when I talk about Microsoft Teams as a gold certified partner with Microsoft Teams, so we'd like to highlight the fact that now, like ma'am was sharing, they've increased the video systems to 48 members. And the number of attendees has increased to close to 300. And it's purely an education segment offering. The A1 license at least is an education segment offering. And all you need to do is verify your school affiliation to get onto that offering. And the other big advantage is the security compliances in place, which is very, very huge in Microsoft. And of course, you have the whole suite, the Office 365 suite that ma'am was again telling, the Office OneNote, the Collaborate, all the files, assignments, conducting quizzes, all that is tightly integrated into your conferencing app itself. So it's not like you have to go to two different apps to conduct your classes or share materials. So this is where the advantage lies. And of course, once you have the content delivery in place, it's like seasoning on the food. You still have to do things right. So apart from getting your right platform, transitioning from offline to online by usage of the different tools that you know that is offered by the tech companies, then prescribing or sticking on to time limits prescribed by the government is again a great idea. And most important is partnership with parents. So unless we have all the stakeholders' confidence, it may not be easy to drive online education and digital etiquette. So this again becomes highly important, because as when we started maybe in May or June, there was a lot of chaos. But now if you see towards July and August, the kids are, you know, very adept at using or even grasping from technology side. So they know what to do. And I think they've kind of come to terms with how online classes are going to be conducted. And teachers are also a little bit at peace. So again, the lesson plans and recording content and storing, this is of utmost importance, because in case the school reopens, instead of repeating the classes, this recording content can come in like a great help to the teachers. So storage can be of great use. Like, it allows around 500,000 videos in Microsoft Streams, and each video can be go up to 50 GB, which is like brilliant for you to create your own repositories. And finally, it is decentralization of work. All said and done, if it's going to be on just one set of teachers or a few teachers, it doesn't work. That we've seen in a number of schools who come back to us. So we have always trained all the teachers to handle it with one coordinator for each class or section. So that works very well when we talk about going online. So I just thought I will touch upon this, because in the survey that we conducted, a lot of teachers that asked, see, when you go online, madam, the late bloomers or students who don't pay attention to classes are staying behind. They're not able to grasp. So how do we engage students? What do we do for people with attention deficit syndrome? So again, there is no one size fits all kind of a solution for this. So engaging video content can play the role here. So if you have wonderful animated videos that you're going to be sharing with your kids, to a large extent, you can grasp their attention. And after the class is over, leaving the recordings on the channel and giving them a timeline to revise and come back, something similar to what Khan Academy is doing, where they come back with the revision and then they present the, you know, classes they've attended to. So that can also help the students. And of course, in Teams, you have an option where you can conduct quizzes and short question answer tests. So evaluation is the key. So if you form a section or a separate section for the late bloomers and kind of quantify and see how much of the subject they've absorbed by conducting small quizzes, just 3 to 5 minutes before we start with the next session, I think that will help with the late bloomers kind of students. And this is something that we've taken from few good practices that our schools are also doing. So this, I just thought I would share this with you. So we are at SchoolSkies, we are also very happy to share that we've onboarded a number of schools onto the Teams SchoolSkies platform successfully without any boundaries. So from Calicut to Thoothukudi, most of the schools are using, and they've unlocked their education and conducting classes very, very efficiently on the platform. And so apart from that, I think when we started in April, May, we decided that the knowledge to go online, or rather, you know, the fear, that fear of going online should be curbed. So we're glad to share that we've conducted more than 200 free webinars to empower educators. We onboarded close to 50,000 students and 1 lakh parents. Almost every 2-3 days, we were onboarding a school during that time, and still it is going on in addition to the existing schools that we are currently servicing. So if you are asking me how exactly SchoolSkies can help, there are 2 major roles that we are playing with as far as, you know, unlocking your school is concerned. One is the account setup, setting up your Microsoft Teams account along with the SchoolSkies profile management, submitting all your affiliations, getting your users onto the Teams. So adding all the teachers, students, and then of course, provisioning your email addresses for all your stakeholders, and recommendations of setting up classes and putting security policies. So that becomes very, very important. So putting security policies like who should be the presenter and who can, you know, whether you want the students to interchat or you don't want them to change their names or share screens. All this can be done from our side. So that's something that can be of great help to the school. And of course, handing over the entire account to the school administrators at the last point. So next would be the skilling of teachers. So like what Mrs. Ma'am was sharing, I think this plays a very, very vital role. If the teachers are motivated and if they're trained to use ICT, then I think it's a smooth sailing for the school. So we can conduct trainings to give you the Microsoft Innovator Educator Certificate on behalf of SchoolSkies as well as APJ. So if you're asking me what is this MIE all about, so this is one certificate that a school can boast of having all teachers who are trained in Microsoft. So Microsoft tools are being taught to the teachers, and it stands very nicely on the teacher's CV as well. So they have access to professional learning community and career development opportunities. Apart from that, they're part of a larger community. So they can be part of the invitation only special events that the Microsoft is conducting. So looking at where things are, if it's going to be a long journey, digital and online, so I think it makes complete sense to undergo this kind of a professional development for the teachers. So this is a typically how example of how a certificate will look with the Microsoft logo and signed by their vice president there. And so this is how a certificate will look, which school can of course put up in their boards, or the teachers can also proudly have it on their CVs. So overall, like, I would like to thank all of you who attended this meeting today very patiently and raised the questions. And I thank ma'am for being here and sharing her success story, and Dr. Ajit Prasad Jain for those wonderful insights. And I like to tell that we want your school to succeed in this journey of going digital. So again, thank all of you on behalf of APJ Consultancy and SchoolSkies. So I again invite you all to join us to learn, share and explore. We have webinars every day at 5 p.m. and we speak about best practices, and we can clarify your doubts on the different platforms, and we can talk about certifications. Please do register for these everyday webinars, and you can take down this number 999-402-1195, or you can probably take a screenshot of this. You can email us at schoolsupport@schoolskies.com. Or if you have any doubts even pertaining to the NEP or anything, do write to ajit@apjedu.in. So I once again wish you all a wonderful journey on going online, and good luck to all of you. And thank you, ma'am and sir. And I think now we're open to question and answer sessions. So if there is any, we can take it right away. So
there are two questions.
Okay.
What are the challenges in classroom management during new normal? I think already I explained this.
Yes.
The new normal in the new classroom for the teachers, what is it? And for the management, what is it? For the principal, what is it? For the transporters, what it is? I already explained. And the second one is, what are the challenges post-pandemic lockdown by parents and classroom management? That also I already explained. Challenges for the parents, and
yes,
what will be the problem in classroom management? Only these are the two questions.
Okay.
One minute.
What is it? I think they're just putting up right now. Practice of pedagogy.
Rather, teachers don't comprehend what is exactly the principle. I'm not very clear about the question, what he is asking.
Yeah, sir. Probably the next question, the practices of pedagogy.
There is, see, neither the pandemic nor the NEP 2020 has changed any pedagogy change.
Okay.
There is no change in the pedagogy. Maybe the change in the pedagogy is, instead of virtual classroom teaching in the class core, we are teaching now, as of now, online teaching. So there is no change in the pedagogy. All remains the same. There may be a change in the question paper pattern, all that, but it is a long time to go for all that. Only March 2023 or 23-24, only we can expect the new changes in the examination pattern, whatever the course may be. Well, NCERT is very clear that only for the academic year 2023, the new syllabus, everything will be ready. We'll be ready only with that, because NCF has to come. It has to go in the public domain. They have to receive comments from general public, principal, parents, stakeholders, industry, everybody. And again, they have to revise it. And then NCF has to come. And based on the NCF, the different boards have to set their syllabus. Therefore, in my opinion, for another 2 years, now we are in 2021, 21-22 and 22-23, there is not going to be any change. The change is only going to take place only from 1/4/2023. So let us wait between these another 2.5 years or 3 years, what is going to happen, how this pandemic is going to take the entire world, we have to wait and watch. So we cannot say anything now.
Okay, so I guess that's fingers crossed for now. And thank you, sir and ma'am, again, and thank you all of you out there who've been part of this event, and wishing you all good luck. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Prasad sir. Thank you, Dr.
Praveena.
Thank you all.
I think let us wait for the snap, huh?
Yes.
Yeah.